Shalom, shalom. I'm Ayaleya, and I'm starting a YouTube channel. And from time to time, I will be uploading my Shabbat dinners. I found this chicken pot pie recipe online, and I would like to share it with others in hopes that they may be able to share it with their family as well. So first, I want to go over the ingredients for the chicken pot pies. I will be preparing two chicken pot pies. Okay. First, you would need rotisserie chicken, but you don't have to use just the rotisserie chicken. You can use beef, turkey, lamb, whatever your likings. You can put whatever meat you like in your chicken, in your pot pie. And also, you will need deep dish pie crust. You get two in a pack, so I'm making two, one for the bottom and then the topping. And also, I will be using 1.5 bags of mixed vegetables, probably about a half of this potato, a half of onion, a tablespoon of butter, 2 cans of cream of chicken soup, 1 can of cream of mushroom, and then these are my seasonings right here. I'm going to use a little bit of Polo chicken flavored bouillon, peppercorn medley, a little bit of oregano, sea salt, garlic powder, and body are complete. And so these are the items that I will be using to make my chicken pot pies. And then I also will, before I put it in the oven, I will get like 1 egg yolk and a little water, mix that together, and I will paint the top of the pie crust to give it a beautiful color and a beautiful flavor. So I'm gonna get started. I will start by chopping up my potato, onion, and also my rotisserie chicken. And I'm gonna step off and do that, and I will be right back. Okay, now that I have my onion, chicken, and also my potato cut up, I will go ahead and boil that, start that boiling for about 15, 20 minutes. We don't want them cooked real soft because it will cook some more in the oven when we put the pole pie in the oven. So we're gonna go ahead and get this show on the road. And just put 15 minutes. So I won't forget about my potatoes right here. Not overcooking them. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and start prepping the pot pie. First, we're going to get some grapeseed oil. Okay. We don't need a lot of grapeseed oil, just a little to saute the onion. Okay, that should be enough. I'll let that warm up a little bit. Let me turn the light on, maybe that'll help a little. While that is warming up, I'm gonna go ahead and open up my cans of cream of chicken and 1 can of cream of mushroom. And just for those beginner cookers, make sure to always keep your hands washed. When I cook, I normally have a sink of water with a little bleach added so I can wash my dishes as I go and also keep my hands clean. And also for your new cookers as well, you want to make sure to rinse your tops off. I normally wash mine inside of the water with the bleach water. Just to keep germs and all that stuff down. Okay. little bit there. Let's go ahead and add the onion. And you know, I think I may add just a tad more onion to it. Up a little more onion, because onion gives flavor. Yes, it does. I don't profess to be the greatest cook in the world, but I sure can follow a mean recipe. And my family eats, so that's one last. Okay. Onion. And we want to cook this till it get a little soft, not mushy soft, but we want it to get a little soft. And this is what we call sauteing it, sauteing the onion. Try to keep it moving around. I don't want it to turn brown on me. While that is cooking as well, we're going to go ahead and add a little salt and pepper to that. Not a lot. And we're gonna put a little of the peppercorn medley on that as well. Okay. Just go ahead and continue to let this saute. And while I'm doing this, I just want to talk a little bit about my channel. One of the main reasons that I wanted to start a YouTube channel is to just add value to others' lives. You know, hoping that my experiences and my life can be a help to someone else coming along. I call it value added to others' lives. And that is one of the main reasons for my channel. Okay, once this here gets a little softer, we can go ahead and add the chicken in. Okay, getting there. That just cook a little longer.
All right, let me stir up this, these potatoes a little bit. Okay, we're getting there. We are getting there. Okay, I will go ahead and add my chicken in. I have quite a bit of chicken. Okay, we're going to add the chicken. Okay, we're going to turn the heat down a little bit, around a little bit over low. We don't want it to cook too fast. We're going to mix that up. I'm going to add a little more salt to it. And the peppercorn. Some garlic powder. One thing I learned from my ish, can't be afraid to use the seasonings. Add the seasonings. Okay, let's stir that up. And I did turn the heat down a little bit, okay? Get that stirred up real good. We getting this party started. All right. Next, we're gonna add the vegetables in there. Each bag is 12 ounces, so about 18 ounces of vegetables, mixed vegetables. Stir that up a little bit. Give it a time, another time to defrost. On that, we just mix all this up. All right, we will go ahead and add in the two cans of cream of chicken, and then the one can of cream of mushroom. And I forgot about the heavy whipping cream. We definitely will be using that. I forgot to get that out the refrigerator and include that in the ingredients. But that is definitely needed. I'll be trying to get all my stuff out the can. Like to leave too much of nothing in it. Just to talk a little bit about the Shabbats. The Shabbats was given to the Israelites in the Bible, and those that cling and serve to Israel, they actually observed the Shabbats as well. And the Shabbat is basically a day of resting. You know, no work, not doing any of your pleasures, not buying and selling on the Shabbat, no cooking on the Shabbat. So it's just a day of rest, not just for your body, but a time to spend time in the Most High Word, building up your spirit. So let me add this can of cream of mushroom. I have a second standby can if I need it. I don't think I will, but I have it. If you're looking for a certain consistency about it. Cream of mushroom came out pretty good. This stirred up real good. Okay. I'm gonna step off for a minute and check the potatoes, make sure they're not too soft. I think they are good. We're gonna go ahead and turn them off. white. We're gonna add a little whipping cream in there to loosen it up a little bit. And get that 1 tablespoon of butter in there for flavor. This on low. Want it on low. Just take your time and mix it up real good. Once we get it mixed up real good, we're going to add some more seasoning to it and give it a taste.
I just need more bags, but the drip to the stove. Said I need more splash. On her tippy toes, she can sneak right past the man.
Let's add a little whipping cream to it, just to loosen it up a little bit. I don't need a hall pass. Watch out for the snakes. And you just want to add a little at a time so you don't overdo it.
Say a hard head, make a soft. Ooh, big time. Number 9.
A little at a time. Taste it to make sure that it is yummy. It is very tasteful, that it tastes as good as it looks. As we all know, looks can be deceiving. Let's take a look. Let's see the hunks of potatoes in there. You see that? All your vegetables. You got plenty of meat. More whipping cream to that, and go ahead and put some seasonings in there. And there's no amount of season or specific amount of seasoning. You just basically season it to your taste. As we use it, just a little bit of oregano off. Yeah. as we go, I'm gonna stir this up real good. And taste it and see if anything else needs to be added. And I know the last time I made this, I made the filling, this is what I'm doing now. I made it the night before, and I let it set in the refrigerator overnight. And I got up probably about 4-5 in the morning before sunrise, Shabbat sunrise. And then I put it in my shells, my pie crust, and put it in the oven then, because it don't take that long to cook once you get this part done. But I think sometimes when you put certain foods in the refrigerator, the coolness does something to the flavor. And this is one of those dishes that putting it in the refrigerator overnight, it just gives it a beautiful flavor. That looks good. I love the consistency of it. It's not too soupy and it's not too thick. So I think we have enough heavy cream in there. Biggest thing is making sure that it is mixed very well. So I'm gonna go ahead and stop right here and take a taste. See what we are missing, if anything. I think it's perfect. I think it is perfect. I don't think I need to add anything else to it. That is good. I think it's well mixed. So I am going to stop the video right here and come back in the morning to show y'all the final steps and the finished product. Okay, let's take a look. Okay. Right, I'm gonna say Layla Tov, and Most High will see you in the morning. All right, Boca Tov. All right, we're gonna do the last part of these pot pies this morning before the sunrise and Shabbat comes in. We basically are going to put the mixture into the pie shells. Put a little water and egg yolk on top just to give it that beautiful shine, and then get it in the oven. And so just follow me along to the end. I'm just warming this up a little bit to loosen it up a little bit this morning. Just to loosen it up. Okay, we're gonna turn the stove on 325. Okay. Then we are going to get the yolk here. Thank you. glaze ready to brush on top of the pie shells. I'm doing that by just using the egg yolk, adding a little water to that. Time to put the filling into the shells. And most likely this is going to be too much, but the last time I made it, it was too much for two shells. We're going to pack them high. Look at that. Great. Big chunks of potato in it. It's almost enough to make three. Alright, we're going to use this second pack to put on top. Alright, difference in apples. That's what makes it good. Broken. Okay, once we get the shells on, gonna press them down. So I just want to share with y'all
how beautiful the crust is and crunchy it is. That's what makes the pot pie real delicious. So I'm just wanting to close this video out and just show y'all the finished part of the chicken pot pies. So I'm gonna say shalom, shalom, Yabaruch.